Hey guys, so this is I'm gonna do a series on, it's gonna be all on beginner stuff, so like complete beginner, no one knows what they're doing. This is gonna be lessons on that kind of thing. So chords and scales, and then what the strings are, and tuning, what frets are, and all that kind of stuff. So it's very beginner. And yeah, so that's just gonna be like a series on that kind of stuff. So this is the first video of the series. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna show you like three basic chords that can like, that are in many different songs. So the chords for this lesson are gonna be E, A, and D. So I'll just let you hear what they sound like, and then I'll show you how to play them. That's E. That's A. That's D. So these metal things, they're steel. You know, those bars, those are frets, and then, actually, I'm not really sure. Actually, it might be the space in between the bars, or the frets, but so anyways, so this is the third fret, because there's 1, 2, 3, third fret. This is the fifth fret, you know, 3, 4, 5, 7, 9, 11, and 12. So 12th fret is your octave. So if you just see the two dots, you know that's the 12th fret. And if you're playing it, you can look down at the guitar and you can see the two dots. So that kind of lets you know it's your octave if you're a beginner and stuff. And it just helps me, because, you know, I'm playing for a bit and then you just, okay, two dots, play this. But anyways, it's the chords, not dots. So on the E chord, you want to use these three fingers, index, middle, and ring finger. I started out using these three, and that wasn't good, because then you have this one and you don't know what you're doing with it. And right here you can like add in little stuff. Like that kind of thing. So you strum all the strings on, for this chord, all the strings, the low E, I'll label the strings, then I'll go to the chords. So this is the low E, A, D, G, B, and high E. You know, these two are the same. That's an octave. Actually, it's several octaves to be exact, but anyways, so the chord, so on your A string, and we count the strings from the bottom, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, so this is your fifth string, the A string is your fifth string, so 1, 2, this is the second fret of the A string. So, remember, we're strumming all the strings, so we have, and that's not the chord yet, that's just the first part. And do that with your middle finger. Yeah. The longer one. Don't want to flip off the camera. So, middle finger goes on the second fret of the fifth string. You can, I'm just going to say the A string, because that's what it's called. So, and then your ring finger goes on the second fret of the D string. So the next string down, you just do the same thing with your middle finger. And you keep those two on. And then you take your first finger and put it on the first fret of the G string. And you strum all the strings right now, and there's your first chord, your E chord, E major. Okay, so that's your first chord. You can like fiddle around with that. And now the next chord we're gonna do is A. And some people play A with just their first finger and they bar. But I find it easier to use these three fingers again, index, middle, and ring finger. And so on this chord, in the A chord, you're not hitting the low E. So just remember, don't hit the low E. Only start from the A. And for this chord, since I said you could just bar it, you can bar it if you want. Just, you don't want to hit the string. You can just kind of lift it. See, it's muted. That's kind of why I do it with these fingers, because it's just cool to hear the open E. So this chord is only on the second fret of the D string, G string, and B string. So first finger, second fret of the D, ring finger, sorry, middle finger, second fret of the G, and ring finger, second fret of the B. So we have, and then start from the A and strum down through all the strings. So that's your A chord. So far we have the E chord, E major, and then the A major. Now the next chord is D. So D is, it's a different configuration. You're still using these three fingers. And you start on the D string. I just do these three chords because they're, you have your E chord, your A chord, and your D chord, you know. It's like the root is these three strings. So what you're gonna do is you hit the D, and then you hit you use your first finger, second fret of the, this is the third string, and it's the G string. And then, so we have so far. And then you take your ring finger, the third fret, so 1, 2, 3 of the B string. So far you have, and then you take your middle finger and place it second fret of the high E. So we have this. And make sure on all these chords that your fingers are pressed down enough so the string won't buzz. Because if you don't press it down. See, it's buzzing. Make sure it's pressed down. Get a nice clean chord. So these are three chords that I just went through. E, A, D. So now I'm just gonna play a little riff, like little song thing. That just get you guys to know like how it would sound in a song. And these chords are really good for like writing songs, because they're just right there, you know, and they're really common chords. So thank you. that's just a little song, and there are many songs. It's not really a song, I just made it up on the spot, actually, but many many songs have these chords in it. So yeah, that's just a short kind of little lesson on the basic three chords. There's way many more chords. I'll show you more on a different lesson. Yeah, so that's basically it on the three basic chords lesson. There are other basic chords, but you know, that'll be a different lesson. I just repeat myself in a way. So yeah, thanks for watching. Hopefully this helped all you beginners out there. Guitar is a great instrument, and if you're having trouble with these chords, just set the guitar down. If you're feeling frustrated, just set it down and pick it up later. But remember, if all of these chords, if you're not, it just takes practice. Just like sitting around, just like. And pretty soon your fingers will develop muscle memory. So you can just like that kind of thing. So yeah, those are three basic chords. More lessons to come. I'll probably do more like on scales, and then how to tune the guitar, that kind of thing, and then more chords also. So yeah, play guitar a lot. It's really fun.